that this parliament rejects the proposal by the committee to increase funding to grant aided schools, right, Honorable Speaker.
Last year, Tororo District Woman MP Sarah Opendi moved a motion in Parliament urging the government to address the exorbitant tuition and non-tuition fees charged by government-aided schools.
One of the issues that I raised, right, Honorable Speaker, is the issue as to why these grant-aided schools charge even higher than private schools within Kampala.
The Education Committee, which presented a report to Parliament today, blamed the exorbitant fees on government's failure to pay salaries for all teachers, forcing fees hike.
In most schools visited, the government wage bill is below 50%, averaging at 20%, save for Chibuli Secondary School and Kawempe Muslim School, that is at 50.6% and 55.1%. respectively.
Cuthbert Abigaba, the vice chairperson of the committee, called on the government to allocate adequate funds to finance wage bills for all government-aided education institutions, allowances and wages for academic and non-academic staff so as to lessen the burden on schools' boards.
Ensuring that trained teachers are deployed. Two, payment of salaries and allowances to teachers. Three, appointing heads for government and grant-aided educational institutions and deploying such heads to institutions in consultation with foundation bodies.
However, the proposal was shot down by Opendi, who said it is high time the government handed back missionary-based schools to religious bodies and focused on its seed schools in rural areas.
And you still charge more? Then what are we doing? How many schools, right, Honorable Speaker, seed secondary schools, are there out there, struggling?
She wondered why public schools with established structures and with 70% of its teachers paid by the government should charge higher fees than the private schools that are meeting all their costs.
They have church fees, they have admission fees, they have application fees. Some schools, right, Honorable Speaker, charge as high as 600,000 after you have applied.
Opendi was supported by other MPs who also rejected the report for failing to sort out the ambiguity in the definition of school fees.
The definition of school fees is defined by each school. When you look at Kisubi, it has 29 items defined as school fees. Kibuli has 15 items defined as school fees.
Government neglecting its responsibility of giving public schools money.
MPs lashed out at the committee for only conducting a field study on schools in Kampala and Wakiso districts. They accused committee members of seeking to save on their per diem rather than traversing other schools across the country.
When you have this sector run impulsively, we are debating the consequences of impulsive planning. You wake up and say, we're increasing pay for science teachers.
They tried to put some schools, the well-to-do schools, to benefit the likes of Budo, to benefit from development fund, the likes of Ntare, when actually our schools never benefited, that they've never attracted any building.
Deputy Speaker Thomas Tayewa ordered the committee to go back and reconsider their report while incorporating the concerns raised by their fellow MPs.
You go back, you study this report again, you update it, you consider members' issues instead of me putting a vote on, and report back after 1 month.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.